you can fly.
You can fly, you can fly, you can fly, you can fly.
Hi everyone, I'm Tinkerbell. Before we get started, can you understand what I'm saying? Good, because most people only hear bells when I talk. This is the story of Peter Pan and a girl named Wendy who believed in him. It begins in the Darling Family Nursery.
Wendy's a dreamer, loves to tell tales. She had two brothers, Michael and John. Here in the nursery, they're watched by their nanny.
Dog.
Of gallant Captain Hook. He's only just the cruelest man who ever was a crook. You have to sing yo-ho, yo-ho, and sing it whenever you come or go,
cause that's the only song we know that pirates sing on ships.
Yo-ho, yo-ho,
yo-ho,
yo-ho, yo-ho.
Each story Wendy can tell is better than one in a book.
A Peter Pan and Tinkerbell, the elegant Captain Hook.
The world's most famous.
Our favorite place in the world is Never Never Land.
Where boys and Indians play at war, and the mermaids frolic near the shore, and every single night, Hook and Peter fight.
Peter Pan, you insolent boy, I'll slash you to ribbons.
I'll cut you into pieces.
Scuttle my bones, I'll slit your gizzard.
Peter, fly, or Captain Hook will catch you.
He caught you.
And hit me, oh rat.
Michael, how dare you call your father?
Not you, Dad. Michael is Peter Pan and John is Captain Hook.
Yes, fine. Now where are my shirt and cufflinks? Nana, do you know?
You'll need to look at the treasure map. The boys made it fine.
Let's see. If I follow the line here, to the dotted line here, to the X marks the... Oh no! Oh no, my shirt!
George, this is no time to play with the children. We're late.
This was my last clean shirt! You are pirates!
I'm not a pirate. I'm an Indian now.
I'm a mermaid.
Wendy, what kind of stories are you putting into these boys' heads?
Thank you.
Oh, they're all slobbery. Wendy, why were these cufflinks under the bed?
That's where Peter Pan hides the pirate's treasure.
You and your ridiculous stories. Captain Crook, Peter Pirate.
Peter Pan.
Pan Pirate Puppycock.
Now, George.
Now, George. Now, George. Now, George will have his say. Wendy, this is your last night sleeping in this room.
What?
You need to be a proper lady. You can't roughhouse with your brothers. You can't stuff their heads with these silly stories. We will have some dignity in this house.
Oh, no, poor Nana.
Poor Nana? This is the last straw. Nana, out for good.
No!
But George, the children love her.
And she loves them. But Nana isn't a proper nursemaid. She's not even human.
Goodbye, Nana.
Don't look at me like that. It's nothing personal. It's just that you're not really a nurse at all. You're, well, a dog. And the children aren't puppies. They're people. Sooner or later, Nana, people need to grow up.
I don't want to grow up if that means being a proper lady.
Why did Dad call Peter Pan Poppycock?
Dad's mean.
Now, he loves you very much.
Don't close the window. He might come back.
Who?
Peter, I found his shadow. He flies here each night from Neverland, which is just past the second star to the right.
Wendy, no such place exists. Good night.
You can show the way.
plane is away.
It's time.
Shadow, it's gotta be around here somewhere. You know, you used to be a lot better at finding stuff like this. You used to be able to find a lost boy in no time.
It can be incredibly frustrating trying to communicate with Peter when he gets distracted.
Tink, why are you chattering so much? I found it. I knew I'd find it quicker than you. Look how amazing my shadow looks. Now I just need to attach it. Get me some soap.
Oh my gosh, it's you! I knew you were real! I knew it! I knew it!
You're Peter Pan and you're real, not just a tale I told.
I'm Wendy. Wendy Morba Angela Darling. You came back with your shadow, right? Wait, are you trying to attach it with soap?
But wait, how'd you lose your shadow?
Girls talk a lot.
Excuse me?
First of all, your nanny is a dog. So that's weird. And second, I was floating outside and she attacked me and grabbed my shadow.
Oh, Nana.
I come every night to listen to your stories.
But my stories are all about you.
That's why I like them. I tell them to the Lost Boys, but I forget some of the details. Look how amazing my shadow looks. I crow when I'm happy.
Oh, Peter, I'm so unhappy. Tomorrow I have to grow up and be a proper lady.
Grow up?
Tomorrow I'm leaving the nursery, which means no more stories.
What? I won't have it. I'm taking you to Neverland. You'll never grow up there.
But what would my mom say?
What's a mom?
What's a mom? Someone who loves you and tells you stories.
Good. You can be our mom.
Ow.
Stop it, Tink.
There's one more thing you should know. Although you see me as a normal-sized girl, I'm really just a 2-inch-tall fairy, which is why my voice sounds like bells to most humans. Now, I really shouldn't have pulled Wendy's hair, but she was going to tell Peter more stories about himself. Peter Pan is an excellent boy, but he can be very conceited.
Kidding me.
Wow!
What's that?
A fairy. One is born each time a baby laughs its first laugh.
Tink, Wendy's my friend and she's coming with us.
Peter is going to take us to Neverland, but how will we get there?
We'll fly, of course. All you have to do is think of a wonderful thought.
Any happy little thought?
Uh-huh.
Like toys on Christmas?
Sleigh bell snow?
Yep, watch me now. Here I go.
He can fly.
He can fly. He can fly.
Now you try.
I'll think of the mermaid lagoon underneath the magic moon.
I'll think I'm in a pirate's cave. I'll think I'm an Indian brave.
Now everybody try. Won't work. What's the matter with you? All it takes is faith and trust. Oh, I forgot. Dust.
Dust?
Yep, just a little bit of pixie dust. Tink, Tinkerbell, I order you.
Try it just once more.
Wish I could rise off the floor.
Okay.
Okay, now you.
It's three stories down.
So?
Are you sure it will work?
Of course I'm sure.
I'm scared.
Believe!
Collecting barnacles on this miserable island.
We ought to be looting ships.
I almost forgot how to set a throat.
Trust me, Jack Sparrow, we're rolling.
Pish posh. Make the ship shine or it's the last shillelagh.
What a rogue and peasant hook am I. Here I sit, stuck in Neverland, plotting my revenge on that diabolic Peach of Pan. Curse you, Pan!
The young poet, Cam?
Oh, if I could only find a secret there, I'd capture him and plunge me colors deep into his sickly sweet heart. But enough, this must be finished. Smee, bring me my map.
Maybe he's in his voice hide in Mermaid's Lagoon?
We've trawled the very depths of Mermaid's Lagoon.
Perhaps in the cave above Cannibal Cove?
We've dynamited every cave in Cannibal Cove.
Maybe somewhere in the Indian Territory?
No, no, no. Of course! I'm brilliant! Those Indians know the island better than anyone! They must know where that insolent knave hides each night! We must capture Tiger Lily!
The Chief's daughter?
And if Tiger Lily won't tell us, we will boil her in oil! What do you say to that?
That ain't good form.
That's good form! Did Pan show good form when he did this to me?
I thought you liked your hook for combing your hair and scratching.
Tis true. If I were a mother, I'd pray to have my children born with this instead of this.
In a way, you could thank Pan.
Oh, but Smee, he threw my hand into the crocodile's maw, and the beast has been licking his lips the rest of me ever since.
But luckily, the croc also saw a clock, which gives off the tick-tock, tick-tock, so you can get away from him before he reaches you. Why? I can almost hear it now.
Oh no! The brute is here! Save me! Save me!
You! Over there! What are you doing?
I'm just feeding the legend creature of the sea.
Not that one! Scoundrels, listen up! Never smile at a crocodile. No, you can't get friendly with the crocodile. Don't be taken in by his welcome grin. He's imagining how well you'd fit within his skin.
Never smile at a crocodile. Never tip your hand and stop to talk a while.
Never walk, run away. Say goodnight, not good day.
Really, I'll never smile, Mr. Crocodile.
And Mr. Smee, you know that deepest fear that gnaws at me?
What fear is that, Ken?
Someday the clock will run down. The beast will sneak up on me and crunch and gnash and pulverize until there's nothing left to me at all. Oh, dear.
Never smile at a crocodile, or you might get eaten by a crocodile.
Yes, it's true. Take a look. Now my hand is a hook.
Clearly, I'll never smile at Mr.
Be gone!
Peter Pan, ahoy!
Swog my eyes! It is Pan! Mr. Smee, pipe up the crew!
Yes, sir!
Mend the long tom, you bilge rats!
I've waited years for this.
Let's not count on the holidays.
Double the powder and shorten the fuse.
Double the powder, shorten the fuse.
Range 42, 3 degrees west.
Range 42, 3 degrees west.
John, look, the Mermaid Lagoon.
There's the Skull Rock.
And there's Captain Hook and pirates. I wonder what they're shooting at.
Look out, they're shooting at us.
Quick, Tink, take Wendy and the boys back to the hideout. I'll fly close and draw Hook's fire. Hook, I'm coming!
Fire the weapons!
He's too close.
Stop floating on water and fight like a man!
Captain, pull your pants up. There may be a lady's wasn't.
If you couldn't fly, I'd get you a box on you, Peter Pan!
Deadly poison tipped ours is how we killed the Wendy bird.
Whose arrow is this? You blockhead! I bring you someone amazing to tell you stories and you kill her?
She was gonna tell us stories.
Hop, you are hereby charged with.
Wait!
My mind's made up, and yet I feel something holding me back.
Is it your conscience?
Nah.
Look, she's not dead.
That was fun.
What happened?
An arrow hit a button on my nightgown.
Why did you do this?
Tink said you wanted us to.
Tink! Tinkerbell, come here! You are hereby charged with high treason. Are you guilty or not? Guilty. Well then, I hereby banish you forever!
ever! Fine, 1 week then, but scram! Wendy, let's find Hook and make him pay for this morning's stunt. John, you're in charge of the Lost Boys. Follow him wherever he leads.
Race ya!
So, you're the Lost Boys? How did you get lost?
When babies fall out of their crypts, they come here to Neverland.
Why are there no lost girls?
Girls are too clever to fall out of their cribs.
Why are you dressed like that?
Camouflage against the Indians.
We're at war with them.
Then we should march. Now what? Psst, lead.
Following the leader, the leader, the leader. We're off on an adventure to capture Indian scouts.
This feels kind of silly.
Yeah.
But I kind of like it. Yeah.
Just march with us. Be part of the brotherhood. And as you march, you're gonna stay young for good. We march and march, cause lost boys never grow up.
Raccoons.
And hawk.
We'll be boys forever, forever, forever. We never will abandon our merry little band. We'll never have to go home, do housework or homework. No one ever grows up, not here in Neverland.
Following the Lost Boys, the Lost Boys, the Lost Boys. Following the Lost Boys before they can catch us. The Lost Boys cannot track us, they want to attack us. We won't let them attack us, and so we track them with us.
See them?
From across the ocean.
Greetings.
For many moons, we native braves have fought with you Lost Boys.
True.
Sometimes you win, sometimes we win.
All right, you win this time. Turn us loose.
Turn us loose? You mean this is only a game?
Yeah, and it does sometimes feel a little bit ridiculous to talk like that. But there is one important thing. Where have you hidden Tiger Lily?
What? We ain't got the princess?
Yes, you do. Tell me, or else.
Honest, we don't.
Then that is a big people from across the ocean lie. If Tiger Lily isn't back by sunset, Lost Boys get burned at the stake.
When you're dry up on the other side, coral and seaweed set up dresses, shimmery lights as fish fly by, air can fill thin till gills grow in, then it's whoosh and the land goodbye.
Wait, Wendy, no!
Why not?
She can tell us stories about you, Peter.
What's it like to fly with him?
They'll clearly keep you there, and they'll forget you need to come up for air.
Truly, good.
Fine then. Tell us one of your adventures.
Want to hear about the time I threw Hook's hand into the crocodile's maw?
There I was, on Marooner's Rock. Wait, Wendy, Tiger Lily.
She's princess of the island, and she's prisoner.
I knew Hulk was up to no good.
How do we rescue her?
Jump in the tale you're telling. Dreams aren't just for sleep. Living that's more compelling.
Thanks, girls. We can take it from here.
Goodbye, Peter.
Come here. I have an idea.
Oh, would that I could set you free. But hey, here's the rub. You know where that scurvy brat Pan lives and I don't. Tell me or die.
You dog.
Shh. Am I not a man of many words, Smee?
Yes, always, Captain. Tigerly, speak up or it's Stevie Jones' locker for you.
And remember your sacred beliefs. There is no path through water to the happy hunting ground. Speak.
Now, Peter.
Odds, bogs, hammer and tongs. Oh, what a rogue and peasant Hook I am.
Who are you, stranger?
James Hook, captain of the Jolly Roger.
But if you are Hook, then who am I?
A codfish.
We have been captained all this time by a codfish?
Fool, this is really some witchcraft. Stay here with the captive. I'll get to the bottom of this.
Mr. Smee.
Yes, Captain?
Release the princess and take her back to her people.
Wait, well, which Captain Hook are you?
The real one.
Okay. I told you Indians wouldn't betray Peter Pan.
Aha! Here's your spirit, Smee.
It's Pan!
Come and get me!
Floating on water again, you cheat! Insolent boy, I'll slash you to ribbons!
You'll cut me to pieces?
I'll slit your gizzard!
Not so fast!
Peter!
Wendy! In the back, Captain?
I've got you this time, Pan!
Cleave him to the brisket!
I'd say, Captain, do you hear something?
Oh, no! Mr. Crocodile, do you like codfish?
Me, the crocodile's here!
I'm coming, Captain!
I'll get you, Pan, I swear! The next time will be worse than anything you can imagine!
Sweet victory! Let's go!
Thank you, brave girl from far away. Because that was a really close one. Come on back to our camp, let's celebrate!
Absolutely!
Flying boy from across the ocean.
Greetings, Chief Tiger Bamboo.
Peter, what is the chief doing?
He's delivering an oration in pantomime. He says, Peter Pan, mighty warrior, saves Princess Tiger Lily, makes chief very glad.
Actually, I was just stretching my arms. Are you the one who saved the princess?
Yep, it was me.
Peter! Then you are hereby renamed Little Flying Eagle, and you can join our tribe.
Flying Eagle! Flying Eagle!
Peter, tell him I helped too.
I will. One more thing, Chief, and it is important. Can you teach me some Indian words?
Well, we don't really know any, but when we want to sound official, we like to say, Hanumanaganda!
Hanumanaganda! Hanumanaganda! Hanumanaganda! Hanumanaganda!
That's fun. One more thing. Why do they call you the Braves?
Because we are brave.
But why?
Hanumanaganda! 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 What makes a brave man? Hanumanaganda, Hanumanaganda, Hanumanaganda. Why do the brave men? Hanumanaganda.
boys should get credit for everything.
There are some boys like that, true, all too proud of what they do, taking credit wherever they can. But if glory they don't share, don't be silent and stare. Tell them quick, tell them true of the noble things in you. Not just boys are fighters, not just boys are strong. Got to keep inside your heart this ancient native song. No one can make you feel small unless you agree to feel strong. What makes the brave girl brave? What makes the brave girl brave? Native girls know many boys have pride so big at first. Just remind him what he did, a girl no doubt did first.
Hanamaniganda, Hanamaniganda, words we sing with pride. Hanami strength, Manami truth, the rest you can decide. Now you got it right from the chief here, each secret sacredly dear. The honor which the natives behave. Strength and truth keep the brave ones.
Those fools celebrating. With that, I could capture Pan now, but he'd only fly away. I must find where those lost boys live. I must have revenge.
Captain, pardon me for saying, but maybe we should forget about this Pan business and Neverland too. Go back to the heavenly normal life on the high seas, sculling ships, cutting throats.
Aye, what life through yonder window breaks?
Feeling poetic, Captain?
No, that light over there. It's Peter Pan's fairy, Tinkerbell. But why is she crying?
I wouldn't want this to go any further, but the cook told me that the first mate told him that Pan banished Tinkerbell.
You should have told me this at once! That gives me a plan.
But how will we get her to talk?
I speak, Pixie.
What is she saying?
She's saying she's very depressed. Poor thing.
He does not speak Pixie, by the way. Just now, he was saying the turnip is taking a siesta. Oh no, let me go!
Miss Bell, I know that you and Pan are dear friends, so allow me to ask you the merest of favors. Please tell Peter that Captain Hook has admitted defeat, and that tomorrow I leave, near to return.
I'm glad to hear that. I'll go tell the crew.
Treacherous me. Yes, all is forgiven. Oh, Pan has his faults. He brought that Wendy to the island after all, and rumor is that she's already come between you and Peter. Then it's true. Oh, Smee, the way of a man with a maid, taking the best years of her life away and then tossing her aside like a glove.
And in a blooming shame.
We must save Peter from Wendy, but how? We sail in the morning. That's it. We get Shanghai Wendy, take her to sea with us, and then Peter would forget his delight in her ridiculous stories.
But come, we don't know where Wendy lives.
What's that? You can tell us where the Lost Boy's secret hideout is? Take this down, Smee, and I promise not to lay a hand or a hook on Peter Pan. Let's go!
They say fairies are either all good or all bad, but that's not true. We can be both, but it's just that we're too small for both feelings to exist at once, and that day I was really seeing that Peter. I wish I could undo this, but it's part of the story. I did it. I told Hook where Peter and Wendy were hiding.
Thank you.
brains. Greetings.
Greetings. Greetings, team.
Greetings.
Big Chief greets little mother. Greetings. Oh, Wendy, is that what I have to say? Everyone else thinks I'm wonderful.
You took all the credit for saving Tiger Lily.
Didn't I save Tiger Lily?
We both did.
Sure.
You're conceited.
I know.
But you shouldn't be.
Okay, I won't be conceited. I'm awfully good at not being conceited. I can be the most wonderfully unconceited person in the world. Big Chief Flying Eagle, magnificently unconceited.
John Michael, take off that war paint and get ready for bed.
Brave, no sleep. Go for days without sleep. Brave ones do a story.
Yeah, a story.
Peter said you came to tell us stories.
Okay. Which one do you want to hear? Cinderella, ooh, or Sleeping Beauty?
Boring. We want Pan.
Pan! 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 Pan!
Mom, tell us the story of Pan.
What did you say?
Mom, tell us the story of Pan.
Michael, you don't actually think I'm your mother. John?
Mothers tell stories. You tell stories. You must be your mother.
I've just been playing. You have a real mom at home. John, Michael, remember?
Did she have silky ears and wear a fur coat?
That was Nana.
I think you had a mother once.
I once had a white rat.
I think it's time we go home.
No, go home. Stay many moons. Have big fun time.
Now, Peter, we've got to be practical. And Indian braves don't even talk like that. Do you just want to stay here and grow up like savages?
Savages!
You'll need a real mom.
Crew, here we are at Peter Pan's secret hideout, finally after all these years.
They're talking.
Wendy, tell us the story of her mother.
She's the lovely voice that bids you good night.
Kisses your cheeks, whispers sleep tight, your
work hard to make sure you have everything you need, and they're good to you, and they protect you. Remember?
But I'm warning you, once you grow up, you can never come back. Never!
Peter, why are you so angry?
I'm not angry! I'll pee in the other room.
Thanks, Cox and Noodler! Come on, it's time to attack!
I want a mother too.
You idiots! Come on!
Should we wait for Pan to come back and kill him?
Smee! I'm appalled at you.
I promised Miss Bell I wouldn't lay a hand or a hook on Peter Pan.
You was being honest? That's not very sporting.
I'll show you sporting. When Pan returns from wherever he is, he'll find his dastardly surprise waiting. Now back to the ship!
Himself.
Ah, the disillusionment of youth. My dear, you are right. Peter won't be doing anything for anyone anymore. Well, not in one location anyway. You see, we've left a present for Peter.
Sort of a surprise suite, you might say.
Why, I can see our friend now. Perhaps he is just reading the tender inscription.
To Peter, with love, from Wendy. Do not eat until 6 o'clock. Huh?
I've made a pie packed the rarest and finest TNT, cooked to a delicious green, which at precisely 6 p.m. will go kaboom.
Kaboom!
No! I promise not to touch it! Fairies, help me!
Why did you call dinner? Why did you call for Peter Pan's pie
deck? Hush up!
And since when did the fairy get jealous of human?
She just gets a little overeager sometimes.
Tink, maybe we should discuss how to avoid situations like this in the future.
You are jealous of Wendy because you want to be the best at everything. But you have the time too, okay?
No time now! Open the jar!
We can't just tell the
story. We have to save it!
Ah, but the fleet of time. Pan has but 18 seconds to live. 15 seconds? 13 seconds?
12 seconds? 11 seconds? Gosh, I want to eat this now.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4.
Hey, Tink, what's up? I can't hear with our friends. Well, hi there, Silver Miss Rosetta. No, wait. You're Lyria. Wait. Hey, give me back my pie.
Hey, we gotta go. This pie's going to explode.
Tink, what do we do?
I'll do it.
Oh,
wasn't a pie. It was a bomb. It was Hook.
Why, if it hadn't been for Tinkerbell, Tinkerbell, you saved my life. I know you're sorry for trying to get Wendy killed. I forgive you.
What? Wendy's in trouble? Let's go.
Now, which will it be? A life of pirate servitude or no life at all?
Captain Hook, we will never join your crew.
As you wish. Ladies first.
Walk the plank! Walk the plank! Walk the plank! Walk the plank!
Goodbye, boys.
Bye, sister.
Wendy!
Come! No splash!
It's a jinx! The ship's bewitched!
This time you've gone too far, Hook! Let's have it out! Once and for all!
It's Peter Pan!
And Wendy!
Come on, let's get them!
Don't just stand there, you bilge rats! Into the breach!
Hook, now it's your turn.
Finally, my revenge. Ooh, you could fly, coward. You wouldn't dare fight Hook man to man on the ship's deck.
No one calls a panda coward in this. I'll fight you back with one hand behind my back.
Peter, it's a trick.
Insolent youth, prepare to die.
Say you're a codfish.
I'm a codfish.
Louder.
I'm a codfish.
Louder.
I'm a codfish.
It's a codfish.
All right, Hook. You're free to go and never return.
Peter! Snee!
I'm going to get him.
The crocodile's here!
Hooray for Captain Pan!
No, hooray for Captain Wendy.
You defeated Hook. You're the captain.
I'll play captain if you play leader.
Well then, Captain Pan, take a straight pass to second star to the right. Tinkerbell, why of course I forgive you, but now I want you to make this ship fly. Will you do that for us?
All right, you swabs. Aloft with you. Man the castmate. Hoist the anchor. Tink, add the pixie dust.
Think.
Michael, we're home.
It's three stories down. That was very irresponsible of you to climb the trellis.
Peter Pan dropped us off here, and you're covered in dirt.
From the pirate ship!
From the garden?
But George, this leaf isn't like any we have in the garden.
Children, how could you scare us like this? We've been worried all night.
It's only been one night.
Of course!
Hush, George. Just be happy they're home. Wendy, you can stay in the nursery and tell stories as long as you like.
No, Mom. The Lost Boys weren't ready to grow up. That's why they went back. But I am. Oh, but Dad, it was amazing. The mermaids and the fairies, and Peter Pan called Hook a codfish. And we were kidnapped. But I knew Peter would save us, even though he's conceited. And then we sailed home through the ship at night.
Your stories are wonderful, Wendy.
No, Mom. They were more than stories. I really flew.
Ha!
And you can fly too, Dad.
It's true.
Think of the happiest things. It's the same of having wings.
Come on.
What? No!
Just humor them, George.
Think of Christmas. Think of snow.
You want me to fly?
George, I take it back. Step away from the window.
Easier than pie. You can fly, you can fly, you can.
Look, it's his ship. I remember.
George, what are you talking about?
You know, when, Nana, did you see that? You know, I have the strangest feeling. When I was a boy, I saw a ship like that. And there was an island and a boy who wouldn't grow up. Oh, Wendy, I understand now. I think I understand.
Oh, Dad.
Come on, Tink. It's time to go back to Neverland.
Goodbye, darling. So long, everyone.
Hang those kids on the line. You gotta make your own sunshine. Make
Thank you, everyone, for joining us this evening for Jungle Book Kids and Peter Pan Jr.